गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दैट वी हैव फिनिश्ड लेसन नंबर वन लैंग्वेज ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एंड वी हैव फिनिश्ड दिस एक्सरसाइज ऑल्सो. नाउ लेट अस बिगिन द चैप्टर नंबर टू, केमिकल चेंजेस एंड रिएक्शन. इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टू स्टडी टाइप ऑफ केमिकल चेंजेस, देन इन दैट हाउ द केमिकल चेंज टेक प्लेस, वॉट डू मीन बाय केमिकल रिएक्शन, देन द टाइप ऑफ chemical reactions, that is there are four type of chemical reactions: direct combination, decomposition, displacement and double decomposition. After that we will see how the chemical reaction take place and the energy changes will take place in that, how the reaction will take place when the absorption of heat, light or electricity will be used to take the chemical reaction. So let us start the first point of the chapter, that is a chemical reaction. Now chemical reaction is the process of breaking of the old bond of the reactant and produce a new bond of the product. See, whenever the chemical reaction take place, there are two reactants were there. When they react, they produce a product, a new substance, that is called as a product. So the reactant having some bond present in them, which is called as a old bond, and the product when the reactant react with one another, they produce a new bond. The new bond is present in the product, and when the old bond is broken down and the new bond will form, that process called as chemical reaction. In the chemical reaction, now bond will broken down and bond will form. So what do you mean by chemical bond? So chemical bond is nothing but it is the type of a force that holds the atoms together in a molecule for forming a new compound. What do you mean by chemical bond? Chemical bond is the force that holds the atom or a molecule together as in a compound. Then see, when a chemical change or a chemical reaction take place, at that time some particles were collide with one another. When the collision occurs, the reactants are come in contact. They supply their energy, their charge from one to another, and then only the reaction will take place. There are few steps, some conditions were there which are very essential for a chemical reaction will take place. So let us see the condition which are necessary for the chemical reaction will take place. Conditions necessary for a chemical reaction take place. So the first is the mixing, or we can say that close contact. See, in the many of the chemical reaction, the reaction will occur only when the two substances are mixed with one another. Especially this condition is required in solid state. Suppose we have two reactants A and B. Okay, A is the first reactant, B is the second reactant. If we are not take them together, we will not mix them together, then the reaction will not take place. Then the product AB, we will not get it. Unless and until we will not add them, we will not get the product. For example, iodine and phosphorus, they react explosively when they brought close in contact. If we take them together, then they start blasting. In the same way, if lead nitrate and potassium iodide, when they react with one another, they produce lead iodide. Okay, so mixing is the important thing where the reactant they will come closed. Unless and until they will not come close, the reaction will not be take place and we will not get the product. Second condition is solution. Solution is the important because in a chemical reaction, the reaction occurs only when the substances are mixed in one another. Sometime what happens when the reaction take place, the reactant are in molten state or in aqueous state or in gaseous state. Okay, so when we will mix them, then only the reaction will take place. For example, we have sodium chloride and silver nitrate. Sodium chloride means NaCl, silver nitrate means AgNO3. Okay, this is aqueous form and this is also in a aqueous form. Okay, so when they react together, this Na will come here with NaO3 and this Ag will go there, so it form AgCl, silver chloride, and NaNO3, that sodium nitrate. Okay, this AgNO3 is nothing but silver chloride and we will get white PPT of it. White PPT means a powdery substance which float over the surface of the liquid. Then the third point is heat. In some of the chemical reaction, heat is play an important role, or we can say that those chemical reaction which occurs only in the presence of heat, those chemical reaction take place under the presence of heat, that reaction called as thermal reaction, where we have to provide heat to that liquid. And for representing heat, we have to give the symbol delta. For example, we have CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate. When we heat this calcium carbonate, then it will give you calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. Okay, in the same way, copper carbonate, when we heat it, then it will give you copper oxide plus carbon dioxide. With the same, if we have water, okay, and we heat it, then we will get H2 plus O2. It should be balanced, so it will balance like this. After that, the fourth point is that light. Okay, so those chemical reaction which take place in the presence of light, that reaction are called as photochemical reaction or photolysis. The chemical reaction take place by the action of light is called as photochemical reaction, and one more name is given, photolysis. Photolysis. Okay, many a reaction, photosynthesis is the best example of photolysis. Then production of HCl, when hydrogen and chlorine react in the presence of sunlight, they produce hydrogen chloride. For example, when hydrogen and chlorine come in contact in the presence of light, it produces HCl. Then plant produce their food, that is photosynthesis, where carbon dioxide come in contact with water, it will produce starch, and water oxygen will come out. For balancing it, we have to balance it by 6 6, and here also it will become 6. So photochemical reaction means those reaction which take place under the presence of light, it is called as photochemical reaction or photolysis. After that, the next is electricity. Those chemical reaction which take place under the presence of light, they are called as electrochemical reaction or electrolysis. Presence of light is called as electrochemical reaction or electrolysis. Okay, electrolysis, just how I told you, when water, it will supplied by electricity, it will give us hydrogen and oxygen separately. In the same way, if sodium chloride is electrolyzed, electricity, then it will give us sodium and chlorine separately. For balancing, we have to balance it like this. So after that, the next point is catalyst. Catalyst is the substance which increase the rate of reaction without taking part in that chemical reaction. Some chemical reaction where catalyst is used to accelerate or to deaccelerate the rate of reaction. And one thing is that the catalyst itself never take part in that chemical reaction. If the catalyst increase the rate of reaction, then it is called as a positive catalyst. If the catalyst decrease the rate of reaction, then it is called as a negative catalyst. So the substance which accelerate or deaccelerate the rate of chemical reaction is called as catalyst. If the speed increase, then it's a positive catalyst. If speed is decrease, then it's a negative catalyst. Okay, so here we will stop today. In the next lecture, we will move towards the characteristics of a chemical reaction. Till then, children, read the lesson, and if you are facing any problem, you can call me, you can ask me anytime. Till then, good day. Stay home, stay safe.